Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 21st, 1975, in Bombay, India.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, Maya Saptamana Patha, Yogam Jinyan Madashaya, असंसार में समग्र माम यथा गैंसि तत्न योग सिस्टम विच इज नोन एज भक्ति योग एवरीवन इज ट्राइंग Not everyone, at the present moment, practically nobody wants to understand what is God. Everyone is busy to fulfill the desires and necessities of the world. Jashafu buddhi kunapi tridhatuke sadhik kalatra deshu haumayibjadhi jatitha buddhi salile nakarhichi janesu abhigyesu saeva gokhara. Gokhara, go means cow and khara means ass. So, according to Vedic culture, one who has accepted this material body as self, ātmabuddhi kunapi tridhatuke, this body is a combination of matter and the living force within this body is not this combination of matter, it is the spirit soul. That one has to understand before coming to the platform of spiritual life. So long one is attached with this material body, it is not possible to understand what is spiritual life. If one continues to be attached to this material body, he is no better than gokhara, cows and asses, animals. So our Vedic culture, Vedic culture means that human culture, not animal culture. Animal culture means to satisfy the needs of the body. And Vedic culture or human culture means to satisfy the needs of the soul. That is the beginning of Bhagavad Gita. One who is reading Bhagavad Gita, in India practically everyone reads, but because one does not take the instruction of Bhagavad Gita as it was instructed by Krishna, he cannot take the benefit of Bhagavad Gita's instruction. One tries to understand Bhagavad Gita by erudite scholarship or good position in the society, political, social, economical. But that is not the way to understand Bhagavad Gita. The way to understand Bhagavad Gita is said in the Bhagavad Gita, Tadvidhi pranipatena paripasnena sevaya upadakshanti tad jnanam jnanina tatva darshina. Unless we approach a person who is representative of Krishna and tattva-darshi, who has seen the truth, jnani and full of knowledge, from him you can understand what is Bhagavad Gita, what is Bhagavan. Otherwise, you cannot understand. Nāhaṁ prakāsa sarvasya jūva māyā samābhita. If you remain covered by the material energy, then you cannot understand Bhagavad Gita. The purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to understand real religious life. Religion means the order which is given by God to carry out. That is religion. Those who are unknown of this fact, they are not religious. They may be some faith or blind belief. But religion means Dharmantu sākṣāt bhagavat pranītam. Religion means the order or the law given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is it. So, to know God, the God, His personality giving instruction. How to know God? Krishna says, Bhagavān Vāca. Here, it is not, Vasudeva is not speaking, Krishna said, because sometimes Krishna is misunderstood. Therefore, Vasudeva writes or says in this connection, Bhagavān Vāca. Bhagavān means the fully opulent samagrasa, aishajyasa samagrasa, bijasa. He is the most powerful, the supreme rich, supreme wise, supreme beautiful, and at the same time supremely renowned. These qualifications makes one Bhagavan. So Krishna Sru Bhagavan Sayam, that is the verdict of Vedic literature. Ishara Parama Krishna. Bhagavan is also sometimes called Parameshara. Ishara means the ruling power of the personality who controls. So, every one of us, we have got some controlling power, either in the society or family or community or government or international. Everyone has got some capacity to control, but nobody is supreme control. Supreme controller means that he is nobody, he is no more controlled by anyone. Other controllers, they are controllers, but they are controlled by somebody else. So Krishna is not that kind of controller. He is the supreme controller, means he controls everyone, but nobody has above him to control. Therefore, he is called Parameshara. Ishara means controller. Ishara Paramah. Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha. He is not Nirakar, Vigraha. Vigraha means form. But his form is different from our form. Therefore he is described as Satchidananda. Sat means eternal, Chit means full of knowledge, and Ananda means full of transcendental bliss, eternal bliss. The beginning is eternal. So, eternal life, eternal or complete full knowledge and eternal bliss. This is the composition of Krishna's body. But murhas, rascals, they think Krishna as ordinary human being. Avajananti mana murha, manasin tanumasu. Fools and rascals, murha. Murha means fools and rascals. Because they see that Krishna is incarnation just like ordinary human being, cousin of Arjuna or nephew of Kunti, like that. Parambhava vajananta. Krishna comes just like ordinary human being, but that does not mean he is ordinary human being. Therefore, Vyasadeva says, Bhagavan was. If you consider Krishna as ordinary human being, then you are missing the point. And I have already given the definition of Bhagavan. One of the qualifications of Bhagavan is Visajasya Samagrasya Vijasya Jasasya Sriya Jnana. He has got full knowledge. He hasn't got to take knowledge from anyone else. Sābhāviki jñāna. Bhagavān means sābhāviki jñāna. Balakriyāj. Natasya kārjam karanam. This is Vedic instruction. Natasya kārjam karanam ca vidyate. Natasya sama adhikasya drishyate. Parāsya sakti vividaiva sriyate. Sābhāviki jñāna. Balakriyāj. Sābhāviki. All full knowledge. Aham sarvasya prabhava, he is the creator of everything. So how he got this knowledge to float these big, big planets in the air? That there is knowledge. There is art. It's like when you float a big airplane in the sky. It requires knowledge. It requires technology, art, it is not flying automatically. That is a mistake. So, if to float an ordinary airship, it requires so much knowledge, so much technology, that how much knowledge is there when you see that the biggest planet, the sun is floating in the air and it is lying in one corner of the sky, and exactly in time it is rotating just sādvaya bhramati saṅghita kāla chakra. There is knowledge, there is art who has fixed it. Therefore, in the Vedas it is said, just sādvaya bhramati saṅghita kāla chakra. He is also rotating in the orbit by the order of Govinda. Govinda Madhi Purusam Tamaham Bajar. So, there are so many things to learn and to understand what is God and what is Krishna. God means Krishna. Krishna is Bhagavan Swayam. Natasya sama adhikasya drishyate. God means nobody is equal to him and nobody is greater than him. That is God. There is no competition that in this quarter there is one God and another neighborhood there is another God. Just like it has become a fashion. So many gods, competition is going on. No. There is no competition. Our God is one. Natasya kajyam karanam se vidyate, natasya sama adhikasya dhishyate. That is God. So, because God is complete in knowledge, therefore we have to take knowledge from Him. Not from the person who has got incomplete knowledge. That knowledge is not perfect. We must take knowledge from the person. We have to take knowledge from the person. Tadvidhi panipatena paripasmena seva upadakshanti tadjnanam jnanina tattva. We have to approach. Tadvijnanatham sa guru meva abhigacchet. We have to approach a superior person, guru, and take knowledge from. The most superior person is Krishna. You may doubt others, that may be, but when you come to Krishna, that is perfect knowledge. Krishna su Bhagavan Sayam, Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vidya. So Krishna is so kind that he comes in one thing, we are calculating. Yesterday, what is, how many years after? You are there? Some billions of years after, we can calculate from the Shastra, because he comes once in the day of Brahma. The Brahma's duration of life is there in the Bhagavad Gita. Sahasra yuga paryantam marahajat brahmano vidhi. 43 lakhs of years multiplied by 1,000 becomes 12 hours of Brahma, and similarly 12 hours at night, that is one day and night, that 30 times makes a month, that 12 times makes a year, and similarly 100 years. Is the duration of life of Brahma. So, according to Shastra, we understand once in the day of Brahma, Krishna appears. Why does he appear? Jada jada hi dharmasya glani bhavati tadatmanam sijami aham. Dharmasya glani. What is that dharmasya glani? Disobedience to Krishna's order. That is dharmasya glani. Jada jada is dharmasya. Dharma is one, as God is one. Similarly, dharma is also one. There cannot be many dharmas. There are many dharmas, practically we see. Hindu dharma, Muslim dharma, Christian dharma, Buddha dharma, this dharma, so many dharma. But real dharma is one. That is explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Sabai pumshan paro dharma. Paro means transcendental. These are material dharma. I am Hindu, you are Muslim, you are Christian, you are this, you are that. These are means an attempt to raise oneself on the platform of real dharma. But real dharma is one for everyone. What is that? Sabai pumshan paro dharma. That is transcendental dharma. Jato bhakti adhokade. The dharma, by following which one becomes a Krishna conscious personal godly person. One understands God, his relationship with him, and acting according to that relation, that is real love. So our everyone, all living entities, dharma means to know that we are eternal servants of God. That is explained by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Jivel Sarupai Nitya Krishna Das. And in the Bhagavad Gita also, Krishna instructs the same dharma that you are the living entity, you are all my part and parcel, and it is your duty to cooperate with me without any reservation. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Dharma Parityaja Mam Ekam Saranam. So, the Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Krishna personally when he was present for the benefit of the human society. For all nations, it is not for the Hindus or the Indians, it is for everyone. God is for everyone. Krishna also says, Sarva Joni Shukanti or Sambhavanti Murtayaja, Aham Bija Padapita, Mamai Vamsa Jiva Bhuta. Every living entity is part and parcel, and he is the supreme father of everyone. So, our Krishna consciousness movement is trying to re-establish the real dharma, not fictitious dharma. That is Bhagavad dharma. In the Srimad Bhagavatam also the same thing is spoken, where Krishna ends Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mam Ekam Saranam Vraja. From the same point, Vyasadeva begins Srimad Bhagavatam. Janmadrasya jataha annaya itaratascha adhishu abhijnasara. And he describes about dharma, dharma prudhita paitavasa. All cheating type of religious system are prudhita. Prudhita means to throw out. Kick out. So our this Krishna consciousness movement is Bhagavad Dharma to teach throughout the whole world that God is great and we are small particles, part and parcel of God. Our duty is to serve God. That is bhakti. Anupillena Krishna Anusilanam. When you favorably serve Krishna, be ready to get orders from Krishna and serve him. That is perfection of life. That is Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mam Ekam Saranam Vraja. And if we daily manufacture a kind of dharma according to my concoction, or we accept everything is real dharma, that is a mistake. Dharma means the order given by God, and if you follow that or execute that order as Arjuna did, then you are dharmic, you are religious. Just like Arjuna, he followed Krishna's order. Krishna wanted him to fight. Of course, you are a Kshatriya. His duty was to fight. And Krishna wanted him to fight. But he was hesitating because the other party with whom he had to fight, they happened to be his family member, most dear kith and kin. Some of them were nephews, some of them gurus, teachers, grandfathers. So, all of them, it was a family fight, so Arjuna was not willing to fight. But Krishna wanted to fight. And after learning from him the essence of Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Dharma Paritya Mami Kami Saranam Vajan, he agreed to fight. That is bhakti. Even by fighting, you can become a devotee. You have to carry out the order of Krishna. That is bhakti. So you must be qualified to know Krishna, then you must be qualified, or automatically you become qualified how to receive his order. This is the way. So unless you understand from where the order is coming, how the order giver is speaking, if you do not know the science, how you can talk with Krishna and receive his order? That is also not very difficult. Krishna says, Sisam satatujuktanang bhajatang priti purbhagam. Anyone who is 24 hours engaged in Krishna's service, satatujuktanang, not sporadic, that 2 minutes I meditate upon Krishna and then 23 hours, 68 minutes, 58 minutes, I remain to satisfy my senses. That is not Krishna bhakti. Krishna bhakti means sadhavijuktana. 24 hours engaged in Krishna consciousness. Just like these boys are being trained up. They have not come to me for some monetary benefit. What monetary benefit I can give to them? They are rather bringing money, and I am constructing big, big temples. Their money. So, still, they are engaged in carrying out my order. There is no payment, no monetary benefit, because they have understood me that he is representative of Krishna. That we have to find out the representative of Krishna. That is also not very difficult. Who is representative of Krishna? Representative of Krishna is he who simply repeats the instruction of Krishna, does not say anything nonsense. He is representative. Krishna says, Manmala bhavamad bhakta madhyajimang namus. He does not say any big, big bombastic thing. Very simple thing. So they always think of me, become my devotee, worship me, and offer obeisance. It doesn't require any PhD education to learn these 4 things. Anyone, even a child can do it. It is very easy. If you daily see the deity in the temple, or if you have got deity at home, even a child will be practiced to think of Krishna. It is not at all easy. And if you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, that is also thinking of Krishna. Samanmana. And if you continue this, then madhvakta, you become a devotee. Manmana bhava madhvakta. Amadhyaji. Then if you can offer to Krishna. Is it very expensive? No. Patram puspam phalam toyam yomi bhaktya pirit. You can offer Krishna little water or a tulsi leaf. Hare Tulsi leaf means not available to any leaf. He does not say Tulsi leaf. So, what is the difficulty to secure a little water, a leaf, or a small flower? Patram, puspam, phalam, toyam. The real thing is bhakti. Patram, puspam, phalam, toyam. So, one bhakta, if you are poorest of the poor, you can become a devotee. Ahituki apratihata, jnatma samprasidati. If you want to become a devotee of Krishna, there is no impediment throughout the three worlds within the universe. You can become a devotee. It is so easy. If you want to be a rich man, it requires so much trouble. Rather, so long you do not desire to become a rich man, you are peaceful. And as soon as you desire to become a rich man, the whole activity begins. How to acquire money? This way, that way, this way. So, everyone tries to become rich man because generally one thinks that at old age I will get some income and I shall sit down very peacefully. So you are already sitting down peacefully. Why you take another means? Of course these things you are not going to discuss. But bhakti means no desire. Anna vilasita asunnam. Then bhakti is very easy. Anna vilasita asunnam, jnana karma dhanabhritam. People are very busy for knowledge and fruitive activities. Everyone in Bombay is working so hard day and night to get some result. And the jnanis, when they are disgusted, they try to become jnani. Jnani generally means one who wants liberation and mukti by merging into the existence. The bhakti is above this. Jnana karma dhanabhritam. If you want to become a bhakta, then you have to disregard the process of fruitive activity and the speculative method of understanding God. Jnana karma dhanabhritam. Then what I have to do? Anukullena krishnanusilanam bhakti yuttama. Simply you have to be ready to execute the order of Krishna, Bhagavan. Anukullena. What Krishna says, you have to do that. Just like a servant. Servant's faithfulness is, as soon as the master orders something, he is ready. You have to be ready. So to become ready to serve Krishna does not require much knowledge or very advanced intuitive activities. These are material things. Spiritually, when you understand that you are eternal servants of God, Krishna, and if you become fully convinced and do the needful, then you are liberated immediately. Mukti means, it is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, mukti hitya anatha rupam sarupena avasthit. If you understand that you are eternal servant of Krishna, that is mukti. And so long you are thinking that you are master of something, that is bondage. This is the difference between mukti and bondage. Bondage means to think of becoming master, I am the lord of this universe, or I am trying to become a lord or master. This is bondage. And when you fully understand Krishna and become engaged in his service, there is mukti. So for a devotee, there is no question of mukti. A devotee is already mukta. Why? Krishna says, aham prasaro papibha mokhaishyami. Immediately, as soon as you surrender to me, immediately I give you protection. You are awaiting some fruitive result of your past karma, that is bondage. You have to take birth and you have to serve according to that karma. that from that position you are immediately liberated. Aham tvasa rupa apimtha moksha shanti. Then you are mukta. So if you remain in the position to serve Krishna, then you are always mukta. Mukti mukulita anjali sevate asma. A great devotee, Billamangal Thakur, he said, this mukti mukulita anjali, with folded hands, she is standing at my door. What can I do for you? Maid servant. The devotee is not after mukti, because they are already muktas. Sarvapadhi vininmuktam tatparasena nirmalam. He is already nirmal, without a tinge of material mode. Therefore, he is able to serve Krishna. Rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhaktirito. So, Krishna personally, instructing Bhagavad Gita to understand him, so we should take advantage of this. Otherwise, we are missing this opportunity, this human form of Christ. Krishna is not teaching Bhagavad Gita to some cats and dogs. He is teaching to the most influential person, Imamaraja Sayobhidhu. So Bhagavad Gita is meant for the Rajarshi, very rich, opulent, at the same time saintly person. Formerly all the kings were Rajarshi, Raja and Rishi combined together. So the Bhagavad Gita is not meant for the lower class. It is to be understood by the heads of the society. Jat jat acharati sreshtha tat tat eva itare jana. So those who are claiming to be the leaders of the society, they must learn Bhagavad Gita, how to become practical and actual leader. Then the society will be benefited. And if we follow the instruction of Bhagavad Gita and Krishna, then all problems will be solved. It is not a sectarian religious sentiment or fanaticism. It is not that. It is a science, social science, political science, cultural science. Everything is there. So our request is that every one of you become a guru. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's order. He wants that everyone must become a guru. How? That he says, Amar ajnaye guru haiya taro yaide. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. This is guru. Suppose you are family members, so many living entities, your sons, your daughters, your daughter-in-law, your children, you can become their guru. Exactly like this, you can sit down in the evening and talk about Bhagavad Gita. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna bole. You haven't got to manufacture something. The instruction is there. You simply repeat and let them hear. You become guru. It is not difficult at all. So that is our preaching. We do not want to become alone guru, but we want to preach in such a way that every the chief man or any man, he can become guru and his surrounding, anyone can do that. Even a coolie, he can also, he has got family, he has got friends. So even though he is illiterate, he can hear the instruction of Krishna and he can preach this thing. This we want. And he invites all respectable gentlemen, leaders, to learn this. It is very simple. Manmana bhava mad bhakta madhyaji mang namaskuru. And by executing this order of Krishna, he assures, Mame Vaisyasi, you come to me. Jagrapyana nivartante tadhyama paramamama. Saktadi ham punajanmanaiti, Mame iti kaunsya. Very easy thing. So our only request is the leaders of the society should take up the teachings of Bhagavad Gita very seriously, learn himself and teach to others. That is Krishna consciousness movement. It is not at all difficult, it's very easy, everyone can do it. But the result will be that as soon as you understand, people understand Krishna, janma karma me dibbam jo janati tattvato. Anyone who understands Krishna, the result is takta deham punarjanma naiti. After giving up this body, he does not accept any more material body. He stays in his spiritual identity and enjoys the society of Krishna. That is Vrindavan. Gopi Jana Vallo. Krishna, Krishna Vrindavan means that Krishna is the center. He is the lovable object of everyone. The gopis, the cowherd's boys, the crops, the cows, the trees, the food, fruits, flowers, the father, mother, everyone is attached to Krishna. That is Vrindavan. So this is the replica, this Vrindavan. And there is real Vrindavan. This is also real. In the absolute, there is no difference. But for our understanding, there is original Vrindavan. Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalvavritkalakabhriti susuraviraviparayantam lakshmi sahasra sata samrama sevamanam govindamadipurisam tamangala dinam tandantam aravindadalathasyam varahavatam samasitam buddhasundarangam sandatva kotikamaniya visesa shobham govindam. This is the description. Goloka, Vrindavan. Oh, there is dham. Antasukuti satavatsa, beyond this material world. So, if we like, we can go there. Madhyadino ki janti ma. Krishna says. You can go to the heart planetary system. Janti deva bhata devan, kitrin janti vitri bhata, bhute janti bhute. Madhyadino ki janti ma. If you are preparing to go to some other better planet, that is the chance in the human being. But if he lives like cats and dogs, then where is promotion, where is Krishna, and where is Goloka, everything is spoiled. So our only request is don't spoil your time, valuable time. Be prepared for being transferred to Krishna, and the method is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Take to it and be bendy. Thank you very much.